share tonight. Most people know by her, but if you don't, you can turn to Psalms 23.
Yes, Lord.
And we can read that collectively when everyone is there. Is everyone there?
Yeah.
Let's start reading. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. So looking at the first portion of that, the Lord is my shepherd. And the beginning of this passage is depicting the relationship between the shepherd and the sheep. Mm-hmm. And it is so important at the very beginning of our walk with God that we establish a real relationship with him. Mm-hmm. And before a shepherd will discipline a sheep, before he begins to lead the sheep, before he begins to protect the sheep, he establishes a solid relationship with them. Mm-hmm. And this involves he will sit down for hours and just talk to the sheep so that they can get used to his voice, so that they will know him, they will know his every movement, they will understand him. And this will be so beneficial towards the end of this passage. He knows them so well that he recognizes them by the beliefs that they make. And even in our spiritual lives, as we go through different things, a lot of times even we can't even necessarily pray, or we can pray, but we don't have the words to pray. We don't know what to say. And God will take those groanings and he will interpret those. And he will take just those cries, and he understands them just by those. He has such a relationship with us at this point. I shall not want. The word want here does not mean just whatever whim that you have, but that means a need. And any good shepherd will make sure that his sheep are not in lack.
My God. Amen.
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. And here it's saying that a sheep will not lay down in the green pasture. A sheep will not relax if there's any danger, if there's any peril around. But the only way they will lay down and they will be at peace is to know that my shepherd is nearby. The sheep will graze around 10 o'clock in the morning, and they will eat around this time. Once they've eaten, they will lay down in these green pastures. And the shepherd will make sure that they are in the prime or the choicest area of a green pasture. They don't just eat anywhere. And even for the mothers, as they're nursing their young, in order for them to have a plenteous milk production, they have to be in the best pasture. And it was saying when I was reading, there's no substitute for that type of nourishment. There's no substitute for that green pasture. And spiritually, it's the same with the church of God. There's no substitution for that. You can't get what you would get here anywhere else in the church of God. The way he wrote this is so beautifully, because the sheep will not drink from a water unless it's still. Because if they do, that will cause physical turmoil. And they cannot drink from a water if their food has not digested. So they have to lie down in a green pasture. And when they lie down and they're laying down, this is when the food is digesting. Once that happens, then he can lead them beside the still water. And the still waters also represent peace and contentment.
Amen. Well, my Lord.
He restores my soul. The word restore means to renew or to restore to its original state. God restores us and he renews us day by day. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. And when we were younger, we would say this, we would run through the scripture. When we got to namesake, I guess as a child, I never understood what that meant, but a namesake is a reputation state. And a shepherd, a good shepherd, has a certain reputation to uphold. And if those sheep are lacking, and if they're in danger, and they're going hungry, that is not an error on the sheep's part, but that's a reflection of the shepherd. God having a perfect reputation, a flawless and infallible reputation.
Amen.
God has lead us in that path for his name's sake. Yes. God has a certain reputation.
My God.
He had the clear and distinct path for our life that he put us in.
Amen.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will when I think about this here, I envision just this big shadow of just this big dark place that you go through in your experience. And what really encouraged me was the fact that it says it's a shadow of death. It's not death, but it's a shadow. And then I wrote down here, a shadow of a serpent cannot sting, nor a shadow of a sword that cannot kill. And these things, when you go through these dark situations, they can discourage. They can cause you to lose your footing if you're not watchful. But it's just a shadow of it. So it can't, a shadow can hurt you. You know what I mean? So if you hold on to God and you go through that, he'll bring you out. Just like in the beginning. Now, a sheep will try to avoid a dark area at all costs. Sheep do not like to go through a dark area. But because in the beginning, how he established that relationship, and they have that trust in him, they will go through because they know that shepherd is with them.
My God.
So the two points that really stuck out with me on this clause is, yea, though I walk through, the word walk through stuck out with me. The word walk through means you are coming out. Yeah. And that means no matter what, how dark the situation is, no matter how dark the situation is, you will not get lost in that valley. You will not die. You will bring you through on the other side. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And the rod, I remember just when I was studying this out previously, and I have been adding to it, but I got two meanings out of the rod, and one was correction, and we know that the Lord, the thing we love is he chastens, and so that is comforting to know that, and it's also protection. He uses that rod to drive away enemies, and when a shepherd boy, or just a shepherd man, whoever, takes on this flock, he takes pride in selecting this rod, because He this rod is shaped to fit his hand. It's almost known as an extension of his right arm. Because that rod and that staff are those two instruments that will always be with him. And he spends hours and hours learning how to throw this rod with precision, with accuracy and speed.
Oh my. It's
like, wow, you know, God is a warrior. Like, he knows how to protect us.
Amen.
He is the best. Like, he is still in battle. God is so mighty. And the next, so I found two more meanings, and the next meaning is found in Ezekiel. Someone can get that. Ezekiel chapter 20, verse 37. Ezekiel 20:37.
I will cause you to pass under the rod, and I will bring you into the bond of the covenant.
Okay. So the rod here is also representing, he uses this to count and to examine the sheep. So when they come, when the sheep are passing on a journey, or they come out of a prep or some type of thicket or wherever, he will hold up this rod and he will take and have them pass under it, and he will do a head count. He's counting to make sure I can account for every single sheep that has been with me. And then he will also, when they come out of these thickets or wherever they're coming out of, he will, from the outside, it can look like, okay, you know, because their wool is so thick, everything can look fine on the outside. But it takes a shepherd, and he will take his rod and he will part that wool.
Yeah.
And he will check to make sure, okay, is it a fly? Is there a some type of pest on him? Is there some type of anything? He will check the skin to make sure they have not been tarnished in any way. He examines them. And even in our spiritual life, there's things that we could look over, or our family members can look over. But that's why David says, search me. You know, God has to search us. And the things that, to our eyes, or to someone's eyes, we would call it something else. But when God searches you, it's in so much detail. And he will find it.
Yes, he will.
The last meaning to me, which is so encouraging as well, can be found in Exodus, and I'm sorry, I think I actually left that scripture in my phone, but when Moses and Aaron went before the Egyptians, and I think this was the first visit, And they stretch, the magician stretched forth their rod, and he stretched forth his rod, and they both became serpents. But his rod devoured the serpents of the Egyptians. And me, what I got out of that was, if he had stretched forth his rod, and nothing would have happened, it would have been almost like a laugh. You know what I mean? It would have been, they would have, almost what could have gotten you, sir? You know what I mean? But when his serpent devoured their serpent, it was a symbol of, I'm with you. So the rod here is representing, I am with you. And spiritually speaking, when we're going through, sometimes you just need to know that God is there.
Yes.
And that is, that's that confirmation.
Amen.
Thy staff, it comforts me. And staff is a long stick with a hook on the end of it.
All right.
And the staff is what I wrote here. More than anything else, this is what identifies the shepherd. And this staff is a direct symbol of God's love, God's concern, God's compassion. He uses this to lead the sheep to the water. And he uses this if a sheep is close by but not close enough, he will put this around the sheep's neck and draw it to him in an intimate way.
That's
what that staff represents.
That's all
he uses the staff to the water to draw him to it and offer for support. You can lean on that staff. You can lean on him when you're going through and you need that extra strength. You can lean on that staff for support. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. And the shepherd, in the physical sense, when he's taking the sheep to graze or to eat, he will prepare the grounds for the sheep. He will weed out the thorns, the weeds, the thistles, anything that's poisonous. He will weed that out. And a lot of times there are different animals that are coyotes and different things that are waiting to devour those sheep, and they're looking on. But that shepherd is there to protect them while they can't even eat in peace, because sheep are so nervous, they can't even eat in peace if they're afraid. So the shepherd is there to guard them as he's spreading this table before them. And spiritually, it's so important for God to treat us this way and to take care of us and to provide for us right there in the presence of those that are looking on, those that are unsaved, those that are enemies, because this is a way for them to see, this is the way I treat my children.
That's right.
You know, this is the way God treats the child, God. Thou anointest my head with oil, and this has a few meanings, I'm going to only hit one. Thou anointest my head with oil. In a Jewish custom, if a guest came to someone's house, and they were just an average individual, you just come in, you eat. But if you were of importance whatsoever, they would take oil and they would anoint your head. And that symbolizes royalty with God. We are not the tail, but we are the head. He treats us as such, and we're not to be tried upon by the enemy. That's just what I got out of that part.
Thank God.
My cup runneth over, and that is a symbol of abundance. We always have enough to carry it. There's never, I can barely make it, or I'm struggling, but God will give us enough to where we're overflowing, where it's spilling over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And I think of goodness and mercy as, I think of like a wedding procession. And the person in front of you is walking inside, and you're behind them, and you kind of use that as a pattern. As you walk, they walk. You go, they go this way. As you proceed through life, goodness and mercy will be right there to follow you. And I just really appreciate this passage. It has been so much to me. It just shows like a picture of how God is just leading you.
Amen.
That relationship. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want, how he will provide for you. And the still waters, the peace, the restoring my soul, the renewal, my cup runneth over. All these things is just showing you the whole journey through life, all